Now we come to the second issue. The second issue was about the conflict among the criteria. So most decisions require trade-off among the objectives because they are conflicting. To solve the conflict among criteria, we use weight for each objective. Weights may reflect how important the attribute or objective is to the decision maker. For the time being, just assume that we have the weights with us. Because we have a technique to elicit weight, that is analytical hierarchy process, AHP. But we will discuss it later on. So that is why just assume that we have the weights of different criteria with us. And of course, just assume that these are the subjective weights. Let's say the weight for price is 0.4, weight for fuel efficiency is 0.4, and weight for comfort index is 0.2. Of course, jab aap kehte na ye subjective hai, to iska ye matlab hai ki they can change or it could vary from one consumer to another consumer, from one person to another person. Lekin, we have a technique to elicit those weights. Hum inko objectivity mein la sakte hain, objective weights bana sakte hain, yani measure kar sakte hain. Again, just at for the time being, just assume these are the weights. Our weights should respect the range of the attribute scale. It means the buyer thinks that the price and the fuel efficiency are equally important and both of them are more important than the comfort. Ye weights abhi aap se kya keh rahe hain? 0.4 for price, 0.4 for your fuel efficiency means ke jis population mein, jin buyers se ye poocha gaya, उन कंज्यूमर्स ने ये कहा कि ये दोनों मेरे लिए बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है उस सर्वे में, और मेरे लिए कंफर्टेबिलिटी इंडेक्स से ज्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट ये दोनों है. नाउ वी हैड दैट टेबल आफ्टर द प्रोपोर्शनल स्कोरिंग. तो प्रोपोर्शनल स्कोरिंग के बाद हमारे पास एक टेबल मौजूद था. हम उस टेबल में ये वेट्स असाइन कर देते हैं. सो इफ यू कैन सी, this is the weight for the price, this is the weight for the fuel efficiency, this is the weight for the comfortability index. Now what we need to do, just aggregate it, simple aggregation kar dein. What does it mean? It means multiply the weight with the corresponding proportional score. So 0.4 into 0, 0.4 into 0, and 0.2 into 1. So my aggregate value would be 0.2. Similarly for Chevrolet, 0.4 into 1 would give me 0.4. Then 0.4 into 0.3 will give me 0.12. And 0.2 into 0 will give me 0. So if I add 0.4 and 0.12, I will get 0.52. which is my aggregating value. Then I have Toyota. 0.4 would be multiplied with 0.6. I will get 0.24. 0.4 into 1 will obviously give me 0.4. And 0.2 into 0.43. So whatever is the value, I will add it and I will get the aggregating value of 0.686 for Toyota. For Volvo, similar in the similar fashion, 0.4 into 0.2, 0.4 into 0.5, and 0.2 into 0.86, I will get the aggregate value of 0.309. Now, which aggregating value is the highest? Of course, Toyota. So, in this simple example of multi-objective decision making, I have resolved the conflict and I have also resolved the issue of having different units of measurement. And after that, based on the three criteria and based on obviously on the weights, Toyota is the best option for me because the aggregating value is the highest. So the highest value hai, wo aapne pick karni hai. So in this case with these specific weights, Toyota is the best one. Now let's assume that weight for price is 0.2 and weight for fuel efficiency is 0.2 and weight for comfort index is 0.6. It means that the buyer thinks that the comfort index is the most important thing to buy a car, and the fuel efficiency and the price are equal and less important. Yani ek population mein aapke paas 0.4, 0.4, 0.2 aur ek aur survey mein from some other demographics, from some other area, it actually gives you different weight. To wo weight se your decision might change. Ye weights jo hain ye subjective hone par dependent hai ab aapki technique is time pe. Until unless you elicit those weights through analytical hierarchy process. Let's say if I want to look that after those weights, now what would be the best car for me to buy? To ab aap dekh le, naye weights aapne assign kar diye. Aur proportional scores wahi hain. Aur aap usi tarah uski aggregating value nikale. To I have the highest value for Volvo now. Why? Because of the comfort index, highest weight for the comfort index. Comfort index ko zyada weight milne se aapke paas Volvo behtar ho gayi hai. Dusre number pe Mercedes aa gayi hai aur Toyota teesre number pe chali gayi. What does it mean? It means your weights actually they affect your decision making here. The subjective weights. So now I am posing two questions here. Of course, we now know how to resolve the conflict and how to resolve the issue of different units. Lekin ek aur cheez humare samne aa gayi hai, that is the weights are subjective. So does the weights for each objective affects the results of decision? One. Question number two would be the weight of for each objective is whether the subjective or objective parameter. You need to think over it. Okay. Aapke your results are actually affected, that is true, by weights. One would say that we can go for a sensitivity analysis, and after sensitivity analysis, which we would know that in what range the weights are applicable. Yani jo weights aapne use kiye hain, wo kis range tak applicable hai. Usse aage jo hai, wo decision change ho sakta hai. Yes, true. But is it a way, do we have a way to actually elicit the weights? Yes, we have. Thank you.